What?
Can't play Game Boy in 2017?
Pokemon.
What do you want me to play? Pokemon Go? On an iPhone? iPod? iPad? How about iPads? Come on now. Handheld gaming is so much better than mobile gaming for a variety of reasons. For example, lack of physical controls, really cash grab nature that I'll get to later, and the inferior quality of mobile games. Ugh, sickening. Take this for example. This right here is a video game controller. I'm sure all of you guys are familiar with one of these. You guys wanna pass that around? It has so many buttons and different, you know, things that you can do, so many options. A phone is a blank screen. So everybody wants to take out their phone if they can. Just imagine playing games on an Xbox, right? You have all those controls. Now play something on a phone. Where are the buttons at? Where are the controls? There's nothing. You're playing on a blank screen. There's no tactile feedback. When you're pressing a button, there's nothing that tells you that you pressed a button. It's a blank screen. And there's this one article by Nicole Lee on Engadget titled, "The iPhone X Leaves a Home Button-Shaped Hole in My Heart." People are upset that the iPhone X doesn't have a home button on it. I mean, these type of things are very important to the common consumer. She said that the home button, there's nothing that could ever like replace the convenience and the practicality. Sure, you swipe it up twice on the new iPhone X. No, nothing will be. It's pressing a physical button that immediately take you home. And another side note, physical elements of the game. When you're playing a game on mobile, it's on your phone or on your account. So if you want to borrow my game, sure, I'll let you borrow my iCloud account so you can have access to all of my personal information, you know, my credit card stuff, so you can, you know, hackers could take that. Or, that's why, you want to borrow FIFA 13? On my PS Vita? Here you go. A physical copy. Look at that. He doesn't have access to any of my vital information. He has a cartridge of my game that I could put in or out of a PlayStation Vita. Now, some people say that it's not cheaper to like download. I mean, people say think it's cheaper to download games than have a physical copy. That's definitely not true in most cases. First of all, I wanted to show that a phone, you know, it's gonna cover the display, but when buying games online, look, $20 for the entire game to download onto your iPhone or iPad. $20. You go to GameStop right now and get a physical copy of the game for $12.99. And if you have a pro card, $10. A physical copy of the game that's yours forever. You have the entire thing for the rest of your life. And then we get to the greedy nature of some of these online games. Free to play doesn't always mean free to play. Free to play is more like pay to play. See these things up in the corner? These dollars, these coins. Up there as well, gold. This in-game currency is just a scheme, a design to take constant money from you 24/7. And these aren't real games. These are like demos that you download because you don't have access to an entire game. Versus when you buy a game at the store, you have the whole thing is there for you forever. On a portable device. Ridiculous. Take FIFA points for example. Say you want to advance in the game, you spend $2 a week in a year. Was that $104? FIFA 13, $5 at GameStop right now. It's playing on a PlayStation Vita. It's yours forever. Never have to worry about it. And a side note, if you want to get FIFA 13 on an iPhone, it's unavailable. You'll never be able to get it. Because it's gone. It's not on the App Store anymore. Here we have just a visual graphics of how the game looks like on an iPhone. FIFA is the latest version, 18. Ridiculous. Look at the Vita version. Much better. Now we're gonna be talking about that. Look how players' faces look in the Vita. Amazing. Almost looks real. What is this? Yeah. What is this? This is the iPhone version, come on. There's a plethora of good games that you can play mobily. You can play Mario Party, Grand Theft Auto on PSP, Pokemon Sun and Moon. These are great, great titles that you can play forever. And there's something called the Nintendo Switch that just came out. So simple to use. Look at that. Physical buttons on a beautiful 720p display. First one, 3 times. I'm in the game right now. So next time you're in a car, you know, and you're about to pull out your phone to play that game, I think you better think twice because there are much better options. Okay.